I remember it being dark. Not cold exactly, just dark. That morning, before anyone else had woken. I could feel the dread weighing on all our hearts. Of everything that the day had before us and all that lay behind. The feeling is almost indescribable, but I'll do my best. Have you ever had to watch someone go through something just terrible, all alone? And the only thing you can do is look. That's how I felt. Helplessness and despair. It was the inevitability of it all. It just felt unreal. We were just peasants, fighting in another man's war. I don't think any of us wanted to be there. But as the sun rose in the east, our enemy before us, time was up. It was quiet, early morning. The sun stood motionless over the horizon as the pennants swayed faintly. Our tents and those of the enemy adorned the rocks. The forest lay between us, but no bird sang. I looked around me at the men who would soon stand and fall, those who would beat and be beaten, those who would be pierced and broken. Their hair swayed gently in the wind. Their weapons were sharp, probably just as sharpened as the enemy's. And they all sat, still as the sun. I sat among them, but I had no glittering armor. I had no helmet to hide my eyes, and my face was not stone-hewn. My gaze was fixed on the seven knights nearest I, who had gathered just ahead on the dry, moss-covered rock. Our soldiers, granite-faced, dressed in red and black. They shone like gold in a cavern. They had all emerged from their tents by now and were busy preparing for the battle to come. Of the seven in front of me, most were hurriedly readying themselves, except for one, who sat motionless. He couldn't have been older than 19. My mind often wanders to him from time to time. I never did find out what he thought of in those final moments. Just then, at the trumpet's call, they all got up and left the rock, to meet the enemy, to break and be broken. In all the time that I have known the little people, all the time that I have lived next to them, eaten the same food as them, kept some of them as friends, I heard that they are supposed to be some of the strangest people that ever set foot on the earth. And always, until that day, I thought I understood them. I thought we were the same. I was wrong. That night, from the cliff, I saw a fire at the other end of the forest. Their celebration. And today I still dream of that music. Their melody had the flavor of victory. Their harmony was like colors woven into my every breath. It goes something like this.